Has anyone else seen it?
Whatever it is,
it's watching and listening.
They are coming. And there's nothing you can do to stop them.
The beginning is always the hardest. You sit in front of a blank screen and you're trying to come up with something new. And sometimes it takes a while. The most difficult thing is to come up with the concept, the melodies, and then the next difficult thing is the arrangements of the pieces, because I feel every project has to have a different feel. This project definitely allowed me to be a little bit more abstract. There's this jump from the present and then the past. It's so complex, it's fun to figure out where you put all the pieces. What I like to do in the beginning is just let the picture run in the background, and then I'll just start to play with ideas to try to capture the mood. Then I'll go in and try that to a specific scene where I go, okay, now I have this theme for this character or for this plot. And I'll try to internally figure out what the tempo would be. The piano is just a great instrument to start out with because it has a great attack, it has sustain, and from there, then I flesh it out and arrange everything around the instrument. When David and Dan told me about this project, the first thing they said to me was, it's going to be a little bit different, it's going to be out there. We're dealing with extraterrestrial life and contact into space. I thought, well, what if we created the music like that? The first theme that I wrote was Ye's theme. I was very intrigued by her story of how it cuts back into the past and you see all the things that happened to her, all the betrayals and the emotions. So when we're in the past, the piano is more out of tune than when it's in the present, just to kind of create that sense of from a while ago, and so that's these little nuances. The theme song, I actually wrote it, I want to say, maybe halfway through the process of writing the score. I knew I wanted something with repeated notes that give the impression that the music is also doing the communication, like a Morse code. So it just starts with the solo piano with our Morse code idea. That's the underlying rhythm of the piece. Now the melody starts. Now a harmony gets added. There's two. And as the picture zooms out, the melody constantly ascends, just like we ascend with the camera. And then we realize we're zooming out from Earth into space, and then the melody repeats, now bigger. And as we go further away, the piece continues to climb. Making sure we keep the tension and the danger here. As a composer, you always feel like, oh, I have something to say. I want to put some notes underneath the scene, but I learned it's okay to push creatively a little bit. It's also okay to make mistakes. I love the recording process. I sit in front of these computer demos for so long, and then once you have actual musicians playing the music, it just elevates the whole thing. Three Body Problem has a special place for me. There's so many nuances you can only do with real musicians, and they bring their emotion into the performance, and it becomes music then.